Ants are eusocial insects of the family Formicidae. Ants appear in the fossil record across the globe in considerable diversity during the latest early Cretaceous and early late Cretaceous, suggesting an earlier origin. More than 10,000 known ant species occur around the world. Ants have colonized almost every landmass on Earth and thrive in most ecosystems and may form 15 to 25% of the terrestrial animal biomass. Ants typically live in structured nest communities that may be located underground in ground-level mounds or in trees. Ants have a major influence on ecosystems worldwide and their roles are diverse. While some ants are considered pests, others act as biological control agents. Ants benefit ecosystems by dispersing seeds, pollinating plants, and improving the quality of soil. Ants might also benefit our health as a potential source of new medicines such as antibiotics. Ant societies have division of labor, communication between individuals, and an ability to solve complex problems. These parallels with human societies have long been an inspiration and subject of study. Ant communities are headed by a queen or queens, whose function in life is to lay thousands of eggs that will ensure the survival of the colony.
The ant communities are headed by queen or queens, whose function in life is to lay thousands of eggs that will ensure the survival of the colony. Male ants often have only one role, that is mating with the queen. After they have performed this function, they may die. Workers are the wingless females that never reproduce, but instead forage for food, care for the queen's offspring, work on the nest, protect the community, and perform many other duties. But there are queenless ants also, that is the Diacamma.
Diacamma is a moderately sized genus of primitive eusocial Bunerine ants which ranges from India to Australia. These ants are characterized by the loss of the morphological queen caste. All female individuals look like ordinary workers, and one of them, called the gamergate, lays eggs for the whole colony. Their colony size is small and varies from 20 to 300 monomorphic adults with a single reproductive individual. The colony consists of worker ants and male ants.
The gamergate systematically bites off the gemmae of all emerging workers. Gemmae means a pair of tiny appendages which is filled with the exocrine cells and is present on the thorax of all emerging workers. And this process of biting off of gemmae is called mutilation. Once mutilated, the Diacamma workers can never mate and are restricted to producing male in colonies without a gamergate.
The workers are monomorphic, forage individually on the ground and on low vegetation, and show a remarkable degree of directional fidelity when foraging. They are apparently generalist predators of arthropods. These mighty creatures are about 12 millimeters in size and are so powerful, it seems like nobody can challenge them. Everything was going well until this tiny little spy found their nest. Within a few minutes, the colony was invaded. small but strong ants are the yellow crazy ants. They feed on invertebrates and will attack, kill and dismember large arthropods. This is a tramp ant, a species that easily becomes established and dominant in new habitat due to traits such as aggression towards other ant species, little aggression towards member of its own species, efficient recruitment, and large colony size. Also known as the long-legged ant or Maldive ant, it is on the list of 100 of world's worst invasive species formulated by the IUCN. They hunt from colony to colony irrespective of the size of its prey. The Diacammas have no other way than running away with their cocoons and larvae. They are running not just for them, but also for the survival of the entire colony. Some of them lost their cocoons during the chase. The crazy ants hunted down most of the colony's population, and the remaining are trying to escape to a more safer place. This grass is a better hideout for the Diacammas since crazy ants cannot follow them there. A dozen of Diacammas and their larvae are now safe from the crazy yellow ants, but the ground is full of hunters. Now the Diacammas can only wait until the last crazy yellow retreats. Those who fail to reach the grass top have to fight with the crazy yellows. Crazy yellows are more in number and are very aggressive. The Diacamma has a secret weapon, the sting. They have a poisonous sting. Insects are paralyzed and killed with their effective stinger.
Humans often show local pain reactions after they got stung by these ants.
The sting seems to be of no use here. The crazy yellow are so quick and they have the deadly formic acid spray. The fight ended up with the death of half the Diacamma colony, and the invaders are now packing their food to their colony. On the next day, the survived Diacammas from the temporary shelter. But they have to move on from here because the nest of the invasive ants is not too far from here. And before emigration, they have to find a suitable place for nesting. A few colony members called explorers look for a new nest to move their entire colony. A fraction of the explorers assumes the role of tandem leaders. In a process called tandem running, each tandem leader leads a follower ant which trails by continually touching the leader's legs and abdomen with its antennae until the pair reach the new nest. The tandem leaders make multiple trips between the two nests until the whole colony is relocated, leaving no one behind. Nestmate recruitment during emigration also occurs through tandem running in Diacamma rugosum, with the hindgut fluid apparently acting as a long-term trail pheromone. The young brood and stored food are transported along with the ants. Tandem leaders optimize the path to new nest and relocate the colony in the shortest possible time.
The sensory systems like visual, olfactory, tactile, and path integration are believed to be involved in choosing the shortest path.
They surround their nest entrances with feathers and ant corps, apparently in order to collect dew. The feathers collect dew drops in the early morning, which the ants can drink and share with the nestmates. The new nest is now ready. But this is not the end of the story. We decided to give them back a cocoon which they lost during the battle. We don't know whether they will receive it or not, but we placed it near to their nest. After a few moments, it won't be a joke believing this cocoon are the future gamma gate of the colony.